You know, it was pointed out to me that Russian Genghis Khan-themed disco pop from West Germany exists, which doesn't sound right. It was also pointed out by 6Y that there was a football team by the name of the Miami Seahawks at one time. And that equally doesn't sound right. So if you're into sports history, that sounds like I'm making it up as I go along, like some sort of strange pro football fan fiction, then, well, you're in luck, as we take a look at the brief history of the Miami Seahawks. The team was originally intended to be a Baltimore club, owned by retired professional boxer Gene Tunney, which never materialized due to the inability to secure Municipal Stadium. A booster club in Miami, led by Harvey Hester and his partner Doug Wyckoff, was able to capitalize upon this and was awarded the franchise, becoming the city of Miami's first major league sports team, competing in the All-American Football Conference. This isn't an NFL team, it's an AAFC team, a league that existed from 1944 until 1949, playing a total of 4 seasons until its merger with the NFL, admitting the 49ers, Browns, Colts, not that Colts, a different Colts, and merged the LA Dons with the Rams. And guess who won all 4 of the league's championship games? The Cleveland Browns. Yes, I meant to say that team's name. Seahawks played their home games at Burdine Stadium, known as the Miami Orange Bowl today, and hired Jack Meagher as head coach. Speaking of home, Miami would only see it once in their first 8 games, giving them one of the more difficult schedules, because, you know, that's fair. However, this was done for a reason, allowing the league to avoid too many cold weather home games. While the Seahawks would see home matches later in the schedule during the colder months in sunny Miami, other teams, like Buffalo, had a reverse schedule, playing home games early before it was too cold, then on the road during winter in places like Miami, Los Angeles, and San Francisco. As for the Miami Seahawks' schedule and results for the 1946 season, let's take a closer look. First, they would face the Browns, and lose 44-0, which by today's standards is one of the worst starts you could have. Next, still on the road, the Seahawks played the 49ers, getting a little better, but still losing 21-14. After this, they would head down to LA and lose to the Dons, 30-14. Finally, the Seahawks would get some mercy, but only a little, as they would play at home, losing to the 49ers, again 34-7. Confirming the local paper's allegations of being woefully inept. But then the team would rally in Buffalo, with their first win defeating the Bison, which is a real team, 17-14, but then lose to the Chicago Rockets, 28-7, which sounds like a fake team, and you guys need to stop vandalizing Wikipedia. After this loss, head coach Meagher would abruptly quit. Ham Poole and Hank Crisp would replace him, working together to run the team for the remainder of the season. Then the Miami Seahawks decided to play baseball for a little bit. They would fall to the Brooklyn Dodgers, 30-7, then lose to the New York Yankees, 24-21. Now the second half of the season begins, and after many road games, the team will now only see Burdine Stadium for the remainder of the season, as the colder months kicked in, playing teams they already faced, resulting in the Seahawks suffering more losses but also finding 2 more wins, including a 31-20 win over the Brooklyn Dodgers, in what would be the team's final game. At the end of the season, the team accumulated $350,000 in debt, and not having the wealthiest of owners to begin with, sold, and became the Baltimore Colts in 1947. Miami wouldn't get another team until 1965, with the AFL's Miami Dolphins, known in actual Dolphin as the... Well, that's all for the Miami Seahawks. And again, shout out to 6Y for pointing out this obscure team. Until next time, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.